Our followers make us who we are, so being honest and upfront and genuine with my readers is 100% a must.
So guys, authenticity is what makes bloggers relatable. You open a window into your world. Why do you think authenticity is so important to you?
So I think as bloggers, we're already authentic by nature, just because when you, as a reader, are looking at a magazine or maybe a bigger website, there's always an editorial voice, and the writers that work for that magazine, they have to take on that voice and that aesthetic. And us as bloggers, we can kind of define it ourselves, which is really exciting, and I think readers really connect with that.
And I think our audience is really smart, like they can tell whether you're authentic or not.
Yeah.
You know, they can look at your Instagram or your blog and they can see, you know, these are things that she likes.
Well, I think it would be hard to be someone that you're not. Yeah. I don't know, like everything that I put, I feel like on my feed is really who I am. And I think it's important to be who you are, not only to yourself, but like to your readers.
There's so much talk in the media world about influencers and being influenced. Where do you guys draw the line when it comes to being influenced and reflecting in yourself and staying authentic?
For me personally, I do get inspired by a lot of other bloggers in the city, but I think there's a line between being influenced by someone and full on copying somebody.
Yeah, exactly. Like I get inspired daily by, you know, other influencers or bloggers or YouTubers or celebrities, but it's taking your role models and kind of flipping it and making it your own.
It's gonna happen. We are gonna be influenced by other people, but I think as long as you take your own spin to what you see and not copying other people, I think that's the way to do it.
I think also another part of that is not falling for trends so much, even though you might see something and it's all on your feed. You kind of think like, would I ever have worn that 6 months ago?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I agree. I think not just in social media, but when you look at trend forecasting, designers are looking at things that came from the past, historically what trends have been, what color schemes are coming back. There's so many things that could possibly influence you that it depends how you assemble those influences to create your own little creation. That's how I look at it.